Operational amplifier is a DC coupled high gain electronic voltage amplifier with a differential input and usually a single ended output. It consists of two inputs. First one is a non-inverting, second one is a inverting, and the power supplies are negative power supply and positive power supply. The output is only one, Vout. Operational amplifier is a DC coupled high gain electronic voltage amplifier with a differential input, usually a single ended output. They are fundamentally voltage amplifying device used with external feedback components like resistor or capacitors. Before we understand the operations of an operational amplifier, we must learn about the operational amplifier characteristics. Open loop voltage gain of operational amplifier is denoted as a AOL. The open loop voltage gain without any feedback for an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. For example, the operational amplifier inputs are V1 and V2. V1 is a non-inverting and V2 is the inverting. The power supplies are V- and V+. The output is the VO. The open loop gain of operational amplifier is denoted as a AOL. The potential difference between input voltages are VD equal to V1 minus V2. The output is equal to gain into potential difference. The output equal to gain into potential difference V1 minus V2. If gain equal to output by input, VO by V1 minus V2. If output is very large, the inputs are very small, the gain equal to infinity, yet the potential difference is equal to zero. Open loop voltage gain, it is denoted as AA. The open loop voltage gain without any feedback for an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. Let the input voltage is Vin. Let A is the open loop voltage gain, then the output voltage is equal to V out equal to A Vi in. CMRR, common mode rejection ratio. Common mode rejection ratio of an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. For example, V1 and V2 input for the operational amplifier and VO is the output. For example, differential inputs, that means V1 minus V2 for the potential difference, and common inputs, that means V1 equal to V2, the input is VC equal to V1 plus V2 by 2. Then from this equation V1 equal to VD plus V2, and from this equation VC equal to V1 plus V2 by 2, but V1 is replaced with the VD plus V2, and VC equal to half VD plus V2. Then V2 equal to VC minus half VD for interchanging this one. Then V1 equal to VD plus VC minus half VD. Then V2 is substituted in this equation. Then first one is a VD and VC minus half VD. Then V1 equal to VC plus half VD. Then V out is equal to A1 is the gaining for this one, and A2 is the gaining for this one. That means V1, V2 are both are substituted in the first equation. The output equal to V out 1 plus V out 2 for non-inverting and inverting. The gainings are A1, A2 for the inverting and non-inverting terminals. That means V out equal to, substituted in this equation, VD into A1 by 2 minus A2 by 2 plus Vc into A1 plus A2. We simplifying this equation, A1 minus A2 by 2 Vd plus A1 plus A2 into Vc. V out is equal to differential mode voltage into A1 minus A2 by 2 plus A1 plus A2 common mode voltage. Then differential mode gaining into Vd plus common mode gaining into Vc is equal to V out. Then where Ad is denoted as A1 minus A2 by 2 and Ac is represent the A1 plus A2. Then CMRR equal to differential mode gaining by common mode gaining, where A1 is the non-inverting gain and A2 is the inverting gain. Then AD into VD equal to differential mode gain output and AC into VC common mode output. Common mode rejection ratio is nothing but differential mode gaining by common mode gaining. For we understand that topic, we explain the simple problem. He given that V1 equal to 0.55 volt and V2 equal to 0.45. We find the V out. He given that CMRR equal to 40 decibels and common mode gaining equal to AC equal to 1. And similarly, value find out the CMRR equal to 40 equal to 20 log 10 into CMRR. Then CMRR equal to 100. Then CMRR equal to 100. Then 100 by 1. That means AD equal to 100. We substitute the value. Output equal to AD into VD plus AC into VC. From this equation, V out equal to AD into VD plus AC into VC. AD value, we know that AD equal to 100 and VD equal to, VD is nothing but 0.55 minus 0.45. That value equal to 0.1. and plus Vc equal to 0.5 and Ac equal to 1. Vd equal to V1 minus Vd equal to 1 and Vc equal to 0.5. then the value equal to output equal to Ad into Vd Ac into Vc is equal to 10.5 volt. Common mode rejection ratio. Common mode rejection ratio. Common mode refers to the situation when the same voltage is applied to the both the inverting and non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. The common mode rejection refers to the ability of the operational amplifier to reject the common mode signal. Now we are in position to understand the term common mode rejection ratio. The common mode rejection ratio refers to the measure of the ability of the operational amplifier to reject the common mode signal. Common mode rejection ratio is equal to AD by SEM. Common mode rejection ratio. Mathematically, it is defined as a CMRR equal to AD by SEM, where AD is the differential gain of operational amplifier. Infinity for an ideal operational amplifier. ACM refer to the common mode gain of operational amplifier. The CMRR of an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. That means it is able to reject all common mode signals. Also from formula, we can see that AD is infinity for an ideal operational amplifier and ACM is equal to 0. Input impedance of an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. What is the impedance? Impedance is the resistance of the circuit. The input impedance is defined as a the input voltage by the input current. Input impedance is defined as the input voltage by the input current. That means the impedance equal to Vi by Ii. It is the infinity for input. For output impedance is denoted as a Z out. It is for operational amplifier, ideal operational amplifier, for output impedance is equal to 0. Output impedance is defined as the ratio of the output voltage to the input current. That means, simple change, the output impedance is defined as the ratio of the output voltage to the input current. That means the output impedance equal to V out by I in. It is equal to 0. First one is input impedance is high, output impedance is equal to 0 for an ideal operational amplifier. Input impedance is defined as the input voltage by the input current. The input impedance of an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. The input impedance of an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. That is, there is no current flowing in the input circuit. However, an ideal operational amplifier has certain current flowing in the input circuit of the magnitude of few pico amperes to a few milli amperes. Output impedance is denoted as a Z out. Output impedance depend as the ratio of the output voltage to the input current. Once again, the output impedance is depend as the ratio of the output voltage to the input current. The output impedance of an ideal operational amplifier is 0. The output impedance of an ideal operational amplifier is 0. However, real operational amplifier have an output impedance of 10 to 20 kilo ohms. An ideal operational amplifier behave like a perfect voltage source delivering current without any internal losses. The internal resistance reduces the voltage able to the load. Slow rate of operational amplifier is infinity. It's defined as voltage by microseconds. The slow rate of an operational amplifier describes how fast the output voltage can change in response to an immediate change in voltage at the input. The higher the value of slow rate, the faster the output can change and the
more easily it can reproduce high frequency signal. Infinity slow rate so that output voltage can change occur. Slow rate is useful for uncompensated output to compensated output. We are using slow rate, we get uncompensated output to compensated output. Slow rate equal to voltage by microseconds equal to 2 pi into f into dpk, where f equal to the highest signal frequency and dpk equal to the maximum peak voltage of the signal. Bandwidth. An ideal operational amplifier has a infinity bandwidth, that is, it can amplify any signals from DC to the highest AC frequencies without any losses. So therefore, an ideal operational amplifier is said to have infinity frequency response. In real operational amplifier, the bandwidth is generally limited. The limit depends on the gain bandwidth product. Gain bandwidth is defined as the frequency where the operational amplifier gain become unitary. Offset voltage. The offset voltage of ideal operational amplifier is zero, which means that the output voltage will be zero if the difference between the inverting and non-inverting terminal is zero. If both the terminals are grounded, the output voltage will be zero. But the real operational amplifier have an offset voltage. That means offset means is nothing but the both inputs are zero, the output will be zero. Characteristics of an ideal operational amplifier: infinity voltage gain, infinity common mode rejection ratio so that the output common mode noise voltage is zero, infinity input impedance so that almost any signal source can derive it and there is no loading of receiving stage, zero output impedance so that the output can derive infinity numbers of other devices, infinity bandwidth so that any frequency signals from 0 to infinity can be amplified without any attenuation, infinity slow rate so that output voltage change occur simultaneously without input voltage change, zero output voltage when input voltage is zero, it is offset voltage. Thank you.